The 1940s look showcased femininity with a hint of attitude. World War II had a major influence on 1940s fashion. Rationing was instituted as a fair way to distribute supplies to citizens. Clothing like full skirts, pleats, cuffs, patch pockets, and attached hoods were banned from clothing. Even wedding gowns felt the pinch from rationing. Shoes were limited to only 6 colors. Laces were limited and also embroidery on shoes. Even things like zippers disappeared from trousers and dresses. Dresses that once used girdles were no longer seen in fashions of the 1940s. Rubbers were in high demand for the war effort since girdles required rubber in their construction. Out they went. Designers got creative. Some created rubber-less girdles, and one designer took a step back and reintroduced whalebone to girdles.
One of the most outrageous looks of the 1940s fashion was the zoot suit. The look consisted of an oversized coat with a cinched waist, which then flared out to the thighs. The coat also had wide lapels and what was called a rape pleat. The pants came up high to the waist. They were wide at the thighs and then tapered at the ankles in what was called a peg leg. The gangster look with this chalk striped suits was popular in America.
Girls and boys fashion. Bobby socks and blue jeans rolled up to the knee was the girls' fashion, and ankle for the boys were a staple. The styles of movie stars also had a great influence on what young people wore.
Accessories. Hats, gloves, and handbags were an important part of the 1940s. Dickies or collars were often worn beneath sweaters instead of blouses. Silk and nylon stockings also disappeared. Nylon supplies were also impacted since it was needed for military use for items such as parachutes. Women of the 1940s found very inventive ways to recreate the look of stockings. A very common practice was using eyebrow pencils to draw seams down the back of legs to create the appearance of stockings. Swimsuits of the day did their part to support the war effort by giving up their midriffs. As a result, a fashion style was born. This was the bikini.
Makeup. 1940s makeup styles were shaped by the times. The look was very simple. Smooth powdered skin with patriotic red lips were a signature. Mascara was added, and this was the base of the look. Eyebrows were shaped into distinct arches, and cheeks had a rosy pink color. No eyeshadow was needed. They were simply lined with liquid liner along the lash line in either black or dark brown.
1940s hairstyles were no less a component of style than an outfit. When women worked in factories during the war, hairstyles were affected. Many women joined the workforce. This affected the long hairstyles, which were popular in the beginning of the decade. Many women had long hairstyles, and it was dangerous in a factory because it could get caught in machinery and cause a serious injury. Women who chose not to cut their long hair wore hairnets made of velvet or yarn called snuds. Men often let their hair grow long and then wore it combed away from the face. The style was sometimes worn with a part on the side, and then the hair was slicked away.
Music. The flavor of jazz.
She went peck, peck, pecking all around. When she spied it on the ground, she took it, my little yellow basket. And if she doesn't bring it back, I think that I will die.
Yeah.
basket, I lost my yellow basket. And if that girlie don't return it, don't know what I'll do. Oh dear, I wonder where my basket can be.
So do we, so do we, so do we, so do we, so do we.
Oh gee, I wish that little girl I could see.
So do we, so do we, so do we, so do we, so do we.
Joy of mine. A tisket, a tasket, I lost my yellow basket. Won't